Hi, I'm Kailani. At the time of filming this, I'm 19 years old and a sophomore in college. I am also a part of the first generation within my family to pursue a four-year bachelor's degree. But this video isn't about that or the steps it took for me to get to college. This video is about the person who made all of that possible. Someone whose resilience has been the backbone of my family. So without further ado, I'd like for you to meet my grandma.
I'm Julita Ibanez. I came from the Philippines and I was born June 15, 1942 in Sinait, Ilocos Sur, the Philippines. And then I came to Hawaii May 14, 1969 with my two sons, Chris and Jesse, and my husband, Alfonso. The place where I grow is like one field. We can plant some rice, and then after we harvest the rice, we can plant vegetables. There's no electricity. We use the lamp. Like that, but water, there is a well in the like in the field, like that, then we have to go there, carry water, there is a big jar, and then I put on top of my head, like that, get that, just like a pot holder, then I put the jar on top of my head, then bring inside the house. That's where we take our drinking water. You don't have too much place to work like that. Not like over here that even though you don't have a degree, you can just go to the hotel or small restaurant to work. Like that. But over there, they don't have that. Yes.
So if you didn't have a degree in the Philippines, what were your options for working?
Just work on the field like that. I can plant something that's how you can earn money to support the family. I had two grandmas. My grandpa, sister, and my mom, the one taking care of us. Because my dad, he came over here 1946 and I was born 1942. It's only 4 years he stayed with us. Because plenty people came 1946 over here. That's why they call the Sakadas. Then they work the sugar cane.
In 1967, nearly 21 years after her father had first immigrated to Hawaii, my grandmother's mother, two sisters, and brother were able to join him in Lahaina, Maui. However, because she had gotten married after her petition papers were originally filed, it would take almost 3 years for my grandmother to also immigrate to Hawaii. When she did in 1969, she was able to take her two sons and husband with her as they settled into a plantation house within the Pioneer Mill encampment. There, she raised all three of her children, with her youngest being born in Maui 2 years after they had arrived.
The life is better over here because, you know, when you work, you get money, can support the family like that. And every 2 weeks you had money, you had paid. And not like in the Philippines, but even though you work and work like that, it's different from here than in the Philippines. I'm proud because I was there, and I'm a Filipino, and then I come over here too.
Throughout this video, you may notice that my grandmother has said support the family multiple times. That's because ensuring her family's survival and creating a foundation for them to eventually thrive has been the driving force of her life. Until her retirement in 2008, my grandmother would constantly work in small restaurants or hotel restaurants, often having two jobs at once to provide for her family. She wanted to ensure that her children and grandchildren had the opportunity to do something she wasn't able to: get a college degree.
I went to college also, but I never finished college. So. I'm studying that, just like education. That's what our ambition before, our plan, me and Nanda Gramalaling, but we never graduate.
Can you just tell me, like, in total, how many different jobs you worked?
Plenty. No, I think around 10. I need more money, you know, for us and for college also, for school. I like them to have a degree so that they can find better place to work like that, and they get more money.
Seeing his college diploma make you feel?
Oh, I feel so happy. The most important, when all my grandchildren graduate from college and they won't have all those degree, and after that they have a job.